Hi, everybody. Thanks so much for joining us today. My name's Jo Cross, and this is my colleague, Hannah Lebon. And together we work at Democracy PR, which is a PR and social agency based in Manchester. You might know us most recently for work we've done with Boo Biney Carr in turning the Twitter storm following a hoax letter into a really nicely well-received, fun CSR opportunity. But today we're here to talk about quite a different award-winning campaign, one that we did on behalf of Hollyoaks called DocYou. So I'm going to let Hannah introduce the campaign.
Okay, well, bullying has a catastrophic effect on 70% of young people in the UK. Basically, a fifth actually have online bullying to extreme cases at least one time every single day. And of those, 20 children per year will actually commit suicide because of this bullying online and actually in the real life as well. Now, don't know about anybody else, but you know, when I was at school, bullying was literally limited to school. It was horrific at the time, but at the end of the day, I went home, I saw my parents, and everything was a little bit better. But kids nowadays, there's just no escape for them. They've got it so much worse than us. And basically, they've got Twitter, and they've got Ask, and they've just Facebook. 58% of kids on Facebook are actually bullied. So it's becoming a more real problem as years go by.
Now, you can say what you like about Hollyoaks. I'm probably about 10 years too old for it, but I still enjoy it with a hangover on a Sunday. But the one thing I really admire Hollyoaks for is it's brave. It's very committed to tackling the issues affecting its target audience head on. So I still remember being 17 and suddenly understanding that yes, boys could get raped too, thanks to the Hollyoaks, thanks to the storyline with Luke. More recently, I understood a little bit more about how anorexia really grips hold of the victims. So even though Hannah knew that it was tearing her family apart, she couldn't escape it. And last year, it turned its attention to cyberbullying.
Now, the Hollyoaks scriptwriters, obviously, they had complete control on this. They knew how to bring this to life on screen. But the thing was, they needed a digital partner to actually bring it to life in real life. Now, Esther, she's a popular character in Hollyoaks, so she can see her on screen now. She's a sixth form student, and we were going to see her closest peers actually turning against her and making her life hell. We'd see her go from this really confident kid with like loads and loads of future prospects to this shell of herself. She was absolutely broken, and we had to basically turn around and show the community this constant, all-consuming effect of online bullying. So within 6 months, viewers saw this huge turnaround in the way Esther was actually performing. With Hollyoaks, we had to make sure that we were going to actually show this every single day, the day-in, day-out effects of online bullying for children nowadays.
And this was Hollyoaks' one main problem. They were only broadcasting 5 days a week for 30 minutes. How on earth would they get their audience to understand that every single minute there would be a new post slating Esther? So that's when they called on us. They needed a digital partner who would really bring this brutality to life.
So we weren't actually selected just because we had this nice idea. I mean, if I don't know anybody, any agencies out there, you know, you all come up with these great ideas or creative ideas. It's fun. But we needed to show that basically we had a vision. We had a bigger vision for Hollyoaks and something that would actually affect people in real life. So we created a world's first, and it was the first fictional social media site that would sit seamlessly with the soap. So we were able to create this whole thing that just worked in with the soap at the same time, total two-screen action. And we created DocYou.
So it's probably easiest to think of DocYou as a fictional Facebook. So it mirrored all the functionality of Facebook. We had lots of comments, likes, there would be videos posted, there would be pictures posted. But instead of it being the content authored by you or me, it was content authored by the fictional characters in Hollyoaks. So it is their laugh out louds and their tag pictures on the weekend that would be seen. And most importantly, it would become an integral part of the Hollyoaks storyline. So you'd see characters actually logging on and going on to DocYou to document their own lives.
It was actually positioned as the brainchild of one of the new characters, Dylan, and he was actually one of the mates of Esther. So Dylan produced this social network. So that his friends, probably quite naively really, could keep in touch. So that's how he positioned it, and that's how it was actually weaved into the storyline. as everyone knows, you know, you never sit down anymore and just watch the television. You know, you're constantly on your iPad or on your mobile. It's complete media meshing to the max. And so for Hollyoaks, DocYou was the thing that actually worked best for this. And you had people watching the show, and at the same time, they could be checking all sorts. They could be checking Twitter and talking about it on Twitter, and they could also be checking DocYou at the same time and seeing these real-life updates from DocYou and from the characters as they're watching the screen. It's updating on their social network. So on top of this, we had to basically fulfill three educational remits. So one of them was that this had to be a 24/7 thing. We had to show that this online bullying happens throughout their lives. It happens from the morning to the afternoon to the evening. It's absolutely non-stop. It takes over people's lives. And also, it was set up by Dylan, and it was set up with absolutely no checks. So this is something that's in the media all the time, that, you know, we need to be checking these social media sites for online bullying. It's a breeding ground for bullying when we don't check, and this is something we were able to address in DocYou.
And thirdly, because the visitors to the site could only see the action, they couldn't participate in it, it had a very important way of showing that by just being turning a blind eye or just being voyeuristic, you're complicit in the bullying. You're almost as bad as the bullies themselves, which in turn generated a call to action.
So after a lot of hard work and coming up with this vision and this idea and making sure it worked all along with this Hollyoaks storyline, we had to turn it around really, really quickly. And we had to turn it around and make it work, engage, entertain, educate within 3 months. So it's really, really tight deadlines.
So the first thing we had to do was actually build a site. Now, because it's a world first, we needed the best in the business. So we sourced people who were well-known, award-winning in Manchester to help us create the wireframe and design a site. Then we actually needed to create the content. And what we wanted to do is create a library of content, which would mean it would replicate the actual look and feel of a social media site. So posts going up every day, every hour, every minute, comments going up, people liking. So the content was always changing, giving visitors a reason to keep returning to see this added value content of what happened to their characters once the cameras stopped rolling.
So as always, with every fabulous idea, you need to check it. So not only the technicalities of this whole project, which was obviously really, really difficult to turn around quickly, but we had to actually check that not only would it work technically, but it would also work for our target audience. So what we did for this, and we've done this, we did this on many, many occasions, it's a great way of finding if your great idea is actually going to work, is we spoke to focus groups of target audience. So we spoke to 16 to 24-year-olds. We did three separate focus groups, and we asked them for, worryingly, their completely honest opinion, which is a bit of a red rag to many 18-year-olds. They're ready to tell you absolutely everything and tell you how rubbish your idea is. But actually, it turned around that we'd hit the nail on the head with this. We'd actually got the idea right. So there's a massive collective sigh of relief in the agency.
So we've got a site in place. Now we needed to spread the word. Now, Hollyoaks have got a fantastic press office. They're all over it when it comes to traditional press. They didn't need any help getting the word out there. Furthermore, they've got a very dedicated audience who tune in every single day to watch Hollyoaks and also support them on their social media channels. So they didn't need help there. Where they needed help was extending news about this very brave storyline and this very brave digital experiment to an audience who aren't already engaged. And that's where we helped. We helped stretch the storyline to a previously untapped audience. We did this through three main tactics. The first being actually engaging teenage bloggers who have no previous interest in Hollyoaks. So we held 7 events inviting 100 bloggers to a Money Can't Buy experience. We invited them to be privy to the screening, exclusive screening of never seen yet footage, episodes that hadn't been broadcast yet. Plus, we allowed them to meet stars from the show. So these bloggers, our bloggers, became part of a very, very exclusive group.
Scarlett Bowman and I play Maddie Morrison.
And I'm Jasmine Franks and I play Esther Blue.
Hi Leeds, thank you so much for giving up your evening to come and hear about our exciting project.
Hi, I'm Dylan. Some of you may know me, most of you don't. But I'm the new annoying kid at school who's always on his camera most of the day. I find it a bit weird too, but there's a method to my madness. And the reason I've invited you, the chosen few, to be involved is because you are going to star in it. A shining star.
Now with all this social networking like Twitter and Facebook and what else? Pinterest and all of that. Blogs and everything. It doesn't end when you leave school at 4:30 or 6:30. It continues throughout the night and you can constantly receive a message, can't you? And your account, whatever it may be. And so it's 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for some people, and it's horrific. It's horrific. And I'm trying to get across how...
It's like there's no escape.
Yeah, it's just you can't get away from bullying with all this social networking nowadays. It's just never ending and it's horrible.
But to cement your promise, I'll ask for just one thing.
Hello, my name's George Smith.
I swear to blog the truth,
the whole truth and nothing but the truth.
To help me serve God.
Now, as cheesy as that film was, we managed to convert the bloggers who attended into ambassadors for our cause. So we got them not just to blog about this new storyline, but they also blogged again and again and again as the storyline unfolded, meaning that this untapped audience were now becoming firm fans of Hollyoaks.
So we used a very cheesy video there to target our teenage bloggers, but we actually ran this campaign for Anti-Bullying Week. So it linked perfectly for mummy bloggers. So mums needing to protect, obviously, their children never would think really to talk about Hollyoaks. So we targeted very high-ranking mummy bloggers and family sites to also talk about this. And we did this exactly the same way as our teenage bloggers. We offered them the exclusive footage, so it made them feel extremely, extremely special. And we gave them this chance then to actually blog about this important thing. But it also gave them the chance to see how shows like Hollyoaks were actually working to effect a change in social situations, which is something that Hollyoaks needed to actually get across. We made the show relevant to their lives, and that was the most important thing. Second most important thing, and probably more important to Hollyoaks, is that we turned them into viewers.
So we've got this army of ambassadors, which is brilliant, but we only had 3 months, so we also had to reach a mass audience at the same time, a mass audience of untapped viewers. So we used Facebook advertising, and we actually created a tagline which really we felt played to the gossipy nature of teenagers, called Gossip, Lies and Videotape, What Will You Uncover on Hollyoaks DocYou? And we target that specifically at teenagers who already had an interest in like-minded shows on Channel 4, like Fresh Meat and Misfits.
So Joe mentioned earlier as well that teamwork was going to be imperative in this whole campaign. So we had to work really seamlessly with the Hollyoaks press office, and we had to work with them to make sure that none of our information, we're talking to bloggers, we're talking on Facebook, we can't let any of this information actually be leaked before they can talk to their press contacts, because that's for them most important. So it's really important if you've got a timely campaign that you're ready to run, that you work with an IP lawyer and make sure that you've got that all protective and that you've got your non-disclosure agreements all in place and that you've got embargoes on things and you're making sure you're protecting all your creative outlets that are going on. It's really, really important to make sure you do that.
But very importantly, we had Hollyoaks asked us to create a storyline which would help inform their own storyline, and DocYou did that. It provided the backbone of the Esther story, and it became it came crucial to the whole storyline being played out, as you'll see in this clip.
I'm looking for the truth, Sinead. And I think I've found it.
That's mine. I've got no way to go to
Lebon. Get up! So, if it was all Ruby, yeah? Why are all these videos shared from a username that links to your email? Hey, and half of these spiteful messages too? So I'm asking you again, was it you? No more lies, Sinead. Were you one of them? Hey, did you bully Esther? Did you? Sinead!
Now, of course, all this is lovely. We've got these bloggers that we've engaged, this amazing site that we've created. We're part of the Hollyoaks storyline. But we needed to make sure that those numbers were fine, but they didn't mean anything unless the messages we were communicating were being broadcast as we wanted them to. So we kept very close tabs on how our project was working throughout to educate and entertain and engage. But these close tabs showed us from day one we thought that we were.
Hollyoaks viewers visited DocYou 350,000 times and we had 1 million page views. So they kept coming back. It wasn't just that it was good content, but it was engaging.
Plus on the Facebook page for Hollyoaks, any comments about DocYou garnered in total 20,000 posts.
And that Facebook advertising worked as well. We had 1,733 additional Facebook likes on the page, plus again over a million likes and the engagements and shares on the page, which showed again that we were actually putting out content that was engaging our users and keeping them there.
And from an SEO point of view, the bloggers that wrote about DocYou also included an inbound link, which meant that not only were they introducing a storyline to their fans and followers, but they were also ranking very highly on Google, so that meant that any searches for Hollyoaks on Google brought up DocYou early on.
Yep. And we kept the press office very happy as well, because nothing was leaked before it was meant to be leaked. So we acted as their right arm as opposed to working against them. We managed to work seamlessly with their agency.
So by way of a recap, our project just lasted 3 months. We had 4 key objectives to meet, and we think we pretty much nailed them all.
So with DocYou, we had to show the destructive nature of cyberbullying, the fact that it infiltrated absolutely every single part of your life. So through DocYou, we were able to show that Esther was trapped and that social media actually can be relentless and bullying there is actual non-stop.
In terms of entertainment, not only was DocYou a central part of the new storyline, but it extended it, providing a very groundbreaking way for viewers to follow the storyline past the 6:30 to 7 p.m. slot.
The audience absolutely loved it, so we were able to entertain and engage. So they loved it because they related to it. They could actually see what was happening in the real life and see also what's happening in this fictional world as well, that it related. We ended up with thousands and thousands of comments of people just saying, this is how I think Esther should deal with it, this is how I think the bully should be dealt with. But not only that, we also ended up with lots of applaud from people just basically saying the DocYou mechanic was something that was groundbreaking and something that other programs should also think about integrating.
And very finally, we had the fourth objective of extending Hollyoaks' current audience. And we did that by tapping into potentially untapped audiences. As a result, the final episode where Esther tried to commit suicide, the culmination of all our project, was seen by 2.5 million people. That is the highest Hollyoaks audience in the past 2 years.
So altogether, it's a brilliant campaign. We've actually just won a Royal Television Award for it for innovation and multi-platform. So Hollyoaks went to pick that up. Esther picked it up for herself. So we're still riding high on this great campaign, even though it only lasted 3 months. So turning around such a short campaign can actually be incredibly, incredibly rewarding. We started out with this vision and this simple idea that we worked through this campaign and made it work seamlessly with all the different platforms. We needed to make people really feel that they understood about cyberbullying, and it's such an important, important issue, especially with us all working in digital. It's really important that we work towards a positive outcome for this. We think we nailed it. We hope we did, and hope you think we did too. We'll be around here for a little while, so if anybody's got any questions or wants to ask anything about the campaign or any other campaigns we've also ran, or have a look at the We Buy Any Car video, then let us know.
Thank you.